Hey, my name is Ben. Thanks for stopping by the channel. If you're interested in electrical videos, make sure you get subscribed and hit the bell to receive a notification when new videos go live. Today, we're going to be talking about the height of receptacles or outlets and switches. And then I'll also give you a few ideas for some unique possibilities that you might want to consider adding to your rough-in project. We'll talk about light switches first, since we happen to be standing right next to one. Now, the standard height is 48 inches, and I'll explain a couple of reasons why that's important. Now, when I say 48 inches, I mean 48 inches to the top. So if you're to make a mark right at 48 inches, that would be the top of your box, would be mounted right at that 48 inch height. Now, it just so happens that sheets of drywall, like what's right here next to me, are 48 inches high. Typically, they're hung horizontally. So when you go to hang your drywall, you don't want to have to cut more than one sheet. So if I pull this tape measure here from the top, I believe these are 8 foot ceilings, I measure down and 48 inches comes to right here above the switch. So I can hang this top sheet of drywall and not be affected by this switch in any way. And then when I go to hang my second sheet of drywall on the bottom here, I'll only have to make one cut and it'll be right at the top edge, which makes it a little bit easier for making your cut. Now, perhaps more importantly, the ADA, in order to have a switch that is mounted at a height that is compliant, the maximum height for a switch is 48 inches. Now, I think that's 48 inches to the center, but if you have 48 inches to the top of the box, we're for sure gonna be fine. Because if I measure up from the floor here, the center of our switch is gonna be at about 46 inches. Now, if you happen to be wiring a kitchen, all of those receptacles that are above the countertop, your countertop is right at about 36 inches, so here would be our countertop right here. And then for the height of the top of the switch, again, it's gonna be 48 inches, which is going to be about 12 inches above the top of the counter. So both your light switches and your above counter receptacles will be mounted at 48 inches to the top of the box. So most general purpose receptacles are gonna be mounted approximately 12 inches above the floor. Now that's 12 inches to the bottom of the box. There's some flexibility with how high you want your boxes to be. So if you're adding additional boxes to your existing house, you may want to match the height of the existing boxes. That's actually what we're doing in this case. And so these boxes are centered at 16 inches. So the top of the box is at 18 inches. So we just go along and mark the top at 18. And mount the box accordingly. If we wanted it to be a 12 inch height, then we would just mark the top as being 16. Again, there's some flexibility there, but just choose something and stay consistent with it. My opinion is that 16 inches to the top of the box is about perfect. So we're in kind of a basement living room area, and we're gonna have a couch probably along this wall. Now that naturally blocks all of your receptacles, so you can't really have access to them. But one suggestion would be to possibly add a receptacle above the back of the couch. You're always looking for a spot to plug in your phone charger, and adding one at that same 48 inch height is about perfect, and you can conveniently plug in your devices and charge them while you're using them if needed. Right here in the corner of this room, this could potentially be right next to the couch. And if that were to be the case, a lot of times you have some kind of an end table that is pushed up against into the corner. And if you want to plug anything in, you're always having to try to like slide the end table out away from the wall or reach down or crawl underneath. So adding a receptacle above the height of whatever your end table is, I think typically if you were to add one at about 36 inches, you should be fine. So consider adding one above wherever you think your end table is going to be. This also applies to bedrooms. So here in this bedroom, you can see how we have the typical receptacles, one on either side of the bed. Those would be next to or under each one of the end tables on either side of the bed. So that's normal. But the same thing applies. If you want to, you can add a second receptacle or simply just move it up a little bit so that it's above the height of that table, so it's easier to plug things in. It doesn't look quite as clean, but if you're going for function, it might be something that's worth adding. In my house, I added a second receptacle right above, and I also put one of those ones that has the USB ports right in it, and it's super convenient and handy for not having to dig around underneath and behind that table.
Right here is the implementation of that concept that I was just explaining. So there's the right-hand side of the bed, and this is the left-hand side of the bed. You can see I've added this receptacle up higher to allow the end table to be below that receptacle so that we can use these outlets for charging phones and easily access them. And then I also have integrated these switches here to control these lights up to the right. This is just a temporary fixture. I'm eventually going to be putting a nicer bedside fixture right there. And the height of these boxes is right at about 30 inches to the bottom of the box before my flooring would have been installed here. And then this light up here was just set to that standard height of 48 inches. Having this all integrated into the wall and being able to control that bedside light is going to be really, really nice. So kind of an added thing that you can do that's not that difficult.
Another spot to consider adding a receptacle is up and right next to the top of a window. And you do that in order to be able to power any sort of decorations or Christmas lights or things like that that you may want to hang and not have a cord coming down and dangling next to and down where kids can reach it. It's kind of somewhat of a hazard. So if you just add a receptacle up next to the top of the window, you'll at least have the option of using it if you ever decide to. Now, sometimes people are concerned about the aesthetic of too many boxes or whatever, but actually I'm not going to talk about that. Right here behind me is a closet, and that's one spot that typically people don't put an outlet in, but I would say there's a few reasons why you might want to consider adding one. The first is that a lot of the new cordless vacuum cleaners obviously have to be recharged, and a lot of people would store their vacuum cleaner in the closet. So if you have a receptacle in there, you can plug that thing in without having to run a cord outside of the closet or have your vacuum cleaner sitting somewhere else. If you have a room that could be used for an office, a lot of times it's convenient to set a couple pieces of equipment like a printer or something that you don't want sitting out all the time in that closet, so adding a couple of receptacles might not be a bad idea. That kind of explains the theory behind the different possibilities, but now I just want to take a couple minutes and show you some real world examples of different houses that have already been wired, as well as a little bit from a hotel, and then also measurements from my own house. So we'll go through and just measure a bunch of locations and point out some ideas that might be helpful as you lay out your receptacle boxes. This receptacle is mounted at about 18 3/4 to the top of the box. I'm guessing what they probably did here is they probably used the hammer method, meaning that they had a hammer as they went around the house. And if you set this hammer on top of that 1.5 2x4, which is what would be this bottom plate behind the drywall, that's almost exactly where that receptacle ended up being. So some people will just do that, you know, because this height is not that critical. But my personal preference, again, 16 inches to the top. Now for the light switches at this project, they did mount their boxes at right at about 48 inches. So that's the same as we had already been talking about. 48 inches there. 48 inches there. 18 3/4. 48. It looks like they mounted those above the counter at 48 as well. See over here, they had to put them a little bit lower to fit underneath this banister, or whatever you call this little stub wall here. So that's only at about 36 inches off the floor. Right here in this little laundry closet, they mounted the height of the dryer outlet at 36 inches and the washer outlet also at 36 inches. So 36 inches might be a good guideline for your utility plugs for the washer and dryer. Hit this pole right here and let me know, what height do you mount your light switches on the projects that you do? The height that I set all of my receptacles to in my personal residence is 16 inches to the top of the receptacle, like I just mentioned. Right here in this closet, this is where all of our media center equipment is. So keep in mind, wherever your media, or like if you're gonna have a whole house audio system is gonna be, make sure you get receptacle boxes placed for that kind of thing. Here's an implementation of adding an outlet or a receptacle up near the top of the window. The height that I set the receptacles up next to the windows at is 6 feet to the bottom of the receptacle. The height of the
outlets, and in this case, this is an under-counter light switch here, is also set to 48 inches. But note that if you run into a situation where you can't get your receptacle all the way up to 48 inches, it's fine. You can drop it down a little bit. Just try to keep it up off the counter enough that you have room for if you're going to put backsplash. And you also just don't want that to be all the way tight down to the bottom if at all possible. But if you need to shift them a little bit, it's totally fine. But for uniformity's sake, if you can just set the top to 48 inches, it seems to make good sense. Adding boxes that are evenly spaced along your staircase gives you flexibility if you wanted to add a pathway light. I actually just use standard receptacles, and then I'm going to plug in a path light that just lights up automatically at night. But you could also put these on a switch if you wanted to be able to control those separately. But either way, just add your boxes and then you can either use them as receptacles or you can add those path lights if you so choose. Just try to keep them evenly spaced and pay attention to where it's positioned on each tread so that it's going to be casting a similar pattern of light each spot where you have a location. Another spot to consider is if you have a room where you think you might add a projector. Make sure that you add a receptacle for that location. Even if you just add it up high on the wall, that's a pretty good option as well. If you don't know 100% sure where your projector is going to be, but you can see here that implementing that makes it much cleaner than if we had to go and run that power from somewhere else. So in a hotel here, I figured I would just check what the height of the receptacles and light switches were. And you can see that this outlet here is set at about 17 inches, which is, you know, very close to that 16 inch that we were talking about. And then up here with the light switch, they do have it mounted a little bit lower at about 46 inches. And I've seen guys do that pretty frequently, holding it down to 46 or so to the top of the box. Perfectly acceptable as well. And here's one more spot next to the sink here, and they've done the same thing, 46 inches to the top. Let me know the height of your receptacles that you place those boxes at. Do you use the hammer method, or do you keep them set to a particular height? Be really curious to know. So hit this pole right here, and I'll put a few different options for the most common heights. Otherwise, you can comment down below and let me know any other methods or thoughts that you guys might have on the height of different boxes and receptacles in a particular setting. So that's all I have for you in this particular video. If you want to see more electrical related videos, click on one of these videos or playlists right here, and I'll see you over there in just a few seconds. If you found this to be helpful, do me a favor, hit that thumbs up button, subscribe down below, and then hit the bell to turn on notifications so that you get notified when I upload or post a new video. Thanks for hanging out today, and let me know if you have any thoughts or other suggestions or ideas down in the comments below, and I'll see you there.